been quite strange, really, because it, in some ways, it's been nice, so, which is a strange thing to say. So I've obviously missed Chris, Grace, Tony, Mark, Nicky and Ada down in Devon. But then up here, I've enjoyed coming down here for a swim most days, enjoyed getting back on my bike again, playing chess with Chris and with a friend's son on WhatsApp. I'm sort of feel as if I've been quite fortunate.
Well, it completely sort of pulled the rug out from under me to begin with.
Yeah.
Because to sort of top up my tutoring and artwork, I usually have about 2 days a week at a part-time job.
Yeah.
That was with hospitality. So obviously that stopped. Because they had to close.
Yeah.
And then obviously the majority of my work is through workshops, and obviously I've been able to do those.
Right.
So thankfully with a big skill we've been working on some online versions of that. But it was quite scary the first few weeks to think, well, as a single mum, how am I gonna cope, you know, feed everybody and generally, you know, keep going. So it was a huge shock, and I think it took a long time to process it all, really. My mother is quite poorly with all sorts of conditions, and she's had a shield. Because we're in different towns and different houses, I haven't been able to go and see her, probably can drop shopping off and run away, but that's been upsetting, because when I do that, she's appreciative, but she's also really sad that she can't sit and chat to us.
Yeah.
So it's been quite hard work. My youngest lives at home with me, my middle daughter lives with my mum, so they've got each other, we've all got somebody, but we can't get together, we can't share that experience and support each other properly.
Yeah.
Well, my parents are both in their 80s, so they've been shielding. I see them occasionally from a distance when I drop off shopping or prescriptions, things like that.
Yeah.
My daughter lives locally too, but she has very young baby twins. So they've been trying to shield them too. It's so hard not to want to cuddle these two little babies, they're gorgeous.
Yeah.
Financially, my main income is from a very small holiday let, which is an annex to our house.
Yeah.
And that obviously had to shut straight away, so there's nothing coming in from there. Thankfully, we're covering some of the bills through the grant that we've been doing. That doesn't pay for our day-to-day shopping bills. So the big skill has been great in offering me that opportunity to help with writing instructions for things that people can do at home out of upcycled materials that they've probably got around the house already.
I will have people coming in here for workshops, but that just had to stop straight away. So immediately all my regular tuition had to stop. Then going out to do workshops had to stop.
Right.
And you have get thrown into this new world. So consequently I've had to start to learn new skills myself. So with the filming and trying to do tutorials, that's been a real challenge. I think I'm getting there. And I think that's really how it's really affected me. But there's been a shift in what we can try and offer other people.
Right.
And that's sort of been where Big Skill have really helped, because having that sort of expertise to help with how to film, how to edit, that's made just the whole thing work better.
We're lucky to live in a really big gardened place, but it's been very strange, really. Well, Ellie is, my daughter is over there with her dog, so we do exercise every morning on weekdays with Joe Wicks. So I do the granny version every other time, but that's helped with. I really don't like exercise, so I thought I'll do something that I don't usually do.
Yeah.
Just not just going walking, but I do that too. So that's been a positive thing. Gardening, because there's loads of weeds.
Yeah, lovely garden, beautiful.
But mostly I've been doing the craft, well, learning how to do a craft video and getting it right, trying to use another program, getting that sort of right, but it took too long. Perfecting those ones that I've done and getting ready for the agricultural online thing was, it gave quite a lot of focus.
You had
a date and everything else seemed sort of drifting. You didn't know what day it was, and but that was
that
quite,
did actually
that was good, because I wanted to do it, and anything you won't do it unless you're pushed in that that way. So I've done lots of planning for more craft things. I've dug out stuff that I used to do, research stuff online quite a lot. Felting group we do in turn time on a Thursday. I've done so an hour in the morning. That's nice to sort of see what other people have done, which I think is going to apply to these craft packs, because people can show what they've done.
Yeah.
And I know that it's really nice to do that, because I've been on a Zoom meeting with usually 6-7 of us.
Have you?
And it works out fine. We're not all talking over each other then. So.
Yeah.
It's affected me in a few ways. I've because of COVID-19, I've been furloughed from my job, which was working for the Hay Festival, which we had to cancel the festival, which is really, really sad for a lot of the community and a lot of the kind of wider population of the UK and the world, because it's such an amazing festival. So it means that I haven't been able to work at all, which has been really strange, or kind of move forward in my career at all. But I guess you've got to embrace this bit of this bit of space that we've got to be to get a bit creative. You know, I've been doing some music and some songwriting, because I'm in a band called the Sundown Jazz Society. So we've been trying to do some like virtual Skype calls and with Zoom, trying to do some songwriting and some covers and trying to do as best as we can. Well, we had a lot of gigs at festivals and other venues. This summer was going to be really, really busy for us. We had a lot of new material to play for everybody, which obviously we can't play now. So I think we're going to try and continue to get our repertoire better and get our original music better and sounding as good as possible, and then trying to book for next year, I guess, and then hopefully we'll be doing some gigs in the winter, so that should be, if all goes to plan, but yeah, hopefully as soon as possible. I've also been making some clay earrings as well, which has been fun. So learnt that skill, which has been good. So yeah, and I think cooking has been something that's been really what I've been really getting into. So
I've been doing some kits. Some of them have been rainbow kits for wet felting, and some of them have been needle felting kits.
Yeah.
And I've come up specifically for the big skill with a mini kit,
okay.
So it's a little bit less money for everyone's feeling a pinch at the moment. So with the needle felting, you can make a little fox brooch or some little badges. You can do any creature you like.
Yeah.
I also do flowers and hearts and things, so there's little, you can do a bunch of those as well.
Lovely.
So you get a pad, two needles, and lots of different colour wool.
I do lots of rag rugging. So I've got things like brooches, you can make a sheep using the rag rug technique, and there's all the materials and the tools that you need for those. Flower or hedgehog, those are all the same. They're rag rug. Then there's disc weaving to make a little friendship bracelet. Everything's in there, all the instructions, everything's there. Stick weaving as well. So these kits
I've got the sticks for the stick weaving, and it's using upcycled t-shirt material, but yarn made out of t-shirts. So once you've done the kit once, you can carry on using the tools to make others. Yep. So there's a snail, a snowman if you're thinking ahead, and a dragonfly.
Tremendous.
For those. And they're all nice and small and very postable.
So you've done some nice videos on our YouTube for Big Skill. And so people can actually watch those, and we're offering some of the packs that we're offering free for people.
Yeah.
Can you just tell us what
packs are? So one of the things I thought, I was making the masks, and I know that we are slightly changing that in a way that we're coming out of lockdown. There's this thing about, do we do a mask, do we not wear a mask? So, but I thought if people had the opportunity to make their own mask, then that's also teaching them some skills.
That's
but it's something
idea.
That they've got.
Yeah.
That if they're feeling a bit vulnerable, then they can have that mask there if they want to. And it's quite a simple process, but it has got a bit of a challenge to it. So it's you know, hopefully it will give those that have done some sewing before another sort of stage in their experience. So there'd be a PDF to go with it. So I'm going to and a film that
Excellent.
We can put up on the Big Skill site, and also perhaps an embroidery one as well. So a little kit.
I love those.
Which would be quite nice, and that's just the hand sewing skills. So you don't have to have a sewing machine.
Yeah.
And you know, anything where we're sort of, I don't know, making people sort of enjoy a process, but still, you know, it's teaching them a skill. Perhaps they've lost, revisit it, or start afresh.
And your videos, you've done quite a few workshops for us, not just sewing skills, but sort of upcycling clothes.
Yes, indeed. So some of those techniques about how to upcycle garments, that's another little film that I could put out.
That'd be great,
How to do trims, how to do repair, just, you know, shortening a pair of trousers, whatever.
Yeah. The sewing would be a bit harder.
Yes.
So it would,
It is, it is, because you have to think about what have people got at home. What is something that, you know, somebody could manage. Even a hand repair on something if they haven't got a sewing machine.
That one you've already seen, the lip balm kit. And we've got, going to have a gold leaf kit. And then there'll be the thread and the needles and bits of embellishment and stuff to make some books, mini books, and possibly leather ones as well. Wire hearts, button hearts, that's nice and easy to make. We've got memory wire, which we'll need the pliers and stuff like that. But you can do fabric bracelets with that as well, and that's nice. You can also do a zip tie fabric bracelet, which is really good, so I'll do a tutorial for that. This can be in a shadow box. And I'll cut out all of the shapes, and you'll get the glue and the box and everything. Shrink plastic, that's really nice, fun one to do. I'll do the background, so you've got the silhouettes and you've got some nice things to copy because you can just go straight through because it's see-through. These are some button bracelets. You've just got a wax cord, and we've got a tutorial for that one ready. And this is the memory wire fabric ones, which you can add wire and big hole beads to. This is the crochet. This is my first ever one, which I liked. And you put clasp on. It's just pieces, strips of material that you do a single chain crochet, and then you can either add a bead or you can sew on pieces. And there's just different ways that you can make bracelet pull ties, so you don't have to have a proper clasp, you can just slip it in and out.
So in February we launched the Standing Up for Peace sculpture project at Saxon Hall, and also the Coffee Crafts and Chat project, And after a couple of workshops, we now had to close down with the lockdown, and we went online, and we've got a YouTube site which we've got quite a few workshops in, and we've also got quite a few sheets, PDFs, that show people how to make various crafts, and we've also got the facility for people to actually get free craft packs. We've had very little take up of that, and we've also found out that a lot of people not as fortunate as me have been getting quite mentally stressed, getting stuck at home, and there's also, I know of three who I know have lost members of the family in the last 2 weeks. So the new project, Remember and Rebuild, which will have a statue, and we'll seek to get people to share their memories, to share their craft projects, to even make various crafts for other people in the community. So that's what the Remember and Rebuild project is, what we want you all to get involved with.
So I want to stress that all these kits are the free, if you come to a workshop before, the free. And if you haven't, if you look on one of our videos, or you send us a photograph of something you've made, then they're free as well. So do sort of take advantage of the free packs, and also if you'd like to share with us how COVID-19 has affected you.
Thank you.